Travellers from high-risk countries are facing tougher restrictions coming into New Zealand as the COVID crisis in India deepens. A new category has been created to cut the number of infected people flying into the country. India, Brazil, Papua New Guinea and Pakistan currently fall into that category. Travellers from those countries will be temporarily restricted to New Zealand citizens, their partners and children. They'll also need evidence of a negative COVID test from an approved lab within 3 days of travel. In India, 99% of intensive care beds are full and hospital oxygen supplies are running out. It's recorded nearly 16 million cases, the second highest after the United States, and 332,000 in the past 24 hours alone, the highest one-day tally anywhere in the world since the start of the pandemic. And yes, more than 184,000 have now died from coronavirus in India. Here's Laura James with the latest developments.
Each cremation, a family in grief. Thousands dying every day. COVID-19 is crippling India's healthcare system. Oxygen in critically short supply.
If we cannot give them oxygen even, what is the situation? The patient comes to the patient will die.
For 2 weeks, no one from India's been able to enter New Zealand, but the door is now set to reopen to our citizens. And this Kiwi couple's relieved.
Very grateful, yeah. And we're looking forward to getting home. And the very fact that as citizens of New Zealand, we weren't able to come home was an awful situation to be in.
They're head teachers at an international school in Mumbai and have recently been given the go-ahead by their employer to head home.
Tony and I have both been fully vaccinated now. And so we know that we're on reduced risk.
But for those who aren't citizens or the partners, children or parents of citizens, travel to New Zealand remains off limits. And that's now not just for India, the government creating a new category of very high risk countries.
India, Brazil, Papua New Guinea and Pakistan are the countries that meet this threshold.
In the past week, there's been nearly 2 million cases in India, 443,000 in Brazil, around 38,000 in Pakistan, and more than 1,000 in Papua New Guinea.
This is expected to reduce the number of potential cases coming here from India alone by three quarters.
Those on work visas here or permanent residents are able to apply to enter the country on compassionate grounds, or they can spend 2 weeks somewhere else first. But there's acknowledgement for many that won't be possible.
Is there a light at the end of the tunnel for those people that are needing to come back?
Look, I think there's a light at the end of the tunnel for all of us. We just don't know how long the tunnel is at this point.
Hundreds of people will be affected, but Kiwis in India grateful they're no longer barred from returning.
The place that is going to be safest for us in our situation is being back home.
With the outbreak happening around them, showing no sign of slowing down.
And Laura joins us live now from outside the Pullman Hotel in Auckland. Also announced today, Laura, changes to the managed isolation system. How will it work now?
Well, new rules are set to separate returnees that have arrived on different dates. It's being called the enhanced cohorting system, and it starts here at the Pullman tomorrow. How it's going to work is passengers arriving in a 96-hour window will be put in the same facility until that facility is full or the 96 hours is up. Hotels will then lock down for 14 days with no additional passengers allowed to enter until the cohort is finished their stay and it's been cleaned in the facility. This is intended to keep those who've just arrived away from people who are about to complete their stay. Now, the Pullman here did close earlier this year amid concerns of transmission within the facility that wasn't picked up until returnees went out into the community. A report released today found there was no conclusion as to how that happened, but changes have been made and it'll be hoped that this new cohorting system will ensure it never happens again.
Ngā mihi e hoa in Tāmaki Makaurau, Laura James.